good evening from Abu Dhabi Masters. My name is Ivan Sokolov, I'm Grandmaster, and I'm going to show the game of the day from Abu Dhabi Masters. The game of the day will be Bironi, 4 pawns attacking a Bironi, and the game is played between best UAE players Salem Abdulrahman and the young Iranian player Asgarizadeh Ahmad. Young Iranian player is playing Bironi as his main repertoire, so Salem playing with white in a must-win situation has chosen for the sharpest line, and sharpest line against Bironi is 4 pawns attack. So let's play first the introduction moves of the 4 pawns attack. So move f4 is characterizing 4 pawns attack. Bishop g7, and now comes important moment, bishop e5 check. This check is important because it forces black to, let's say, disorganize, disconnect his pieces, because knight of b7 is the best move for black. The problem is that in the case of bishop b7, e5 is very unpleasant move, and leads to bad position for black. While move knight e7 has also been played, and also e5 is a problem, which leads to positions better for white. So knight of b7 is the best theoretical move. But later black would need to spend some time to place this knight on a better square. Most of the times it happens. So now white has to decide whether or not he wants to prevent black from pushing his pawns later on the queen side. If white wants to do this, then he needs to play move like a4, which prevents black from playing a6 and b5, but on the other hand, loses time. So playing with white, Salem, he decides not to lose this time, and he plays move knight f3. a6, bishop d3. So white has actually lost, let's say, one tempi, because this bishop went to b5 and back to b3, while black played the useful Bironi move a6. But on the other hand, this check was needed because black knight on d7 is far from perfectly placed. b5, castle, castle, queen e1, rook e8. This is important position for this variation. And preparing for this game, Salem has decided to play move a3, move which I have played myself against Grandmaster Panzulaya in Dubai Open 2013. I won this game with white, with a sharp fight. We did analyze this game of mine, which I won, and came to some improvements for white. Anyhow, I think that we understood position reasonably well, and that's why today Salem decided to play a3, the move which I have tested about a year ago. Knight f6. Knight f6 is one of the logical moves, actually. Black has here 4 logical moves. One is b4, which was played by Panzulaya in this mentioned game against me. Second one is c5. Third one is knight b6. And the fourth one is move played in the game, which is knight f6. Knight f6 certainly has its logic behind. Knight is targeting white center. But now it happens what I was saying about this bishop e5 check. Virtually, white has won a tempo, because black lost 2 moves and white lost only 1. Queen h4 is a logical move here, because white is preparing to push f5 and to play bishop g5, and now white develops queen. Also, white is protecting against direct threat, because black had a threat to play b4, and then the knight moves to take knight e5 because of this pin. After queen h4, it is always important to notice that white pawn is well protected, white pawn on e4, because it can never be taken because of queen d8. And then black knight on e4 will fall. Black here played a little bit unusual move, perhaps. Knight h5. White does not want to go for ending, so white plays move queen f2, which is logical move. And black retreats knight to f6. Okay, white queen on f2 is certainly better placed than on e1. And white is obviously not going to go for a draw by move repetition. White has here a number of possibilities at his disposal. For example, even some move like h3 is possible, because black does not really threaten to take white pawn on e4, because after b4, a b4, c b4, knight a4, knight e4, takes, white has knight g6, knight b6, and in the case of bishop d4, which is the only way to prevent material losses, because on rook a7 there is knight c8 move. And then after bishop d4, white can take knight b4, queen takes b6, let's say bishop e3, and white has tremendous compensation for only one sacrificed pawn. But white judges that actually this with this queen on f2, more or less this tempo 1, the time is right to start action. And white plays move f5. F5 is a typical way for a white to proceed in this position. Yes, white surrenders e5 square, but on the other hand, white opens space for his bishop. Now, in the case of, let's say, knight g4, if black would try to occupy this e5 square, queen g3, knight e5, there is a move bishop g5, and black would not have a good answer, because if queen moves, there is move f6, and if white plays f, black plays f6, there is move knight e5. And then rook takes e5, bishop f4 will cost a black exchange. While, for example, d takes e6, bishop e3 is clearly better for white. And on the other hand, move like f takes g5 does not really work because of, amongst other things, probably knight g4 with a threat to push f6. So black decided to develop the other knight, which is a logical move. And now black wants to play knight g4 and knight e5. White plays bishop g5, pinning black queen. Queen b6. Black wants to get ready to push c4 at the time and suits. And bishop c2, white removes bishop from a potential tempi. A5. Black has to search for counterplay. And black wants to play move bishop a6 and b4. And black has this poor majority on the queen side, so, like in any Benoni, he gets to push it. Now white does typical Benoni sacrifice, e5. Pawn is sacrificed in order to allow white pieces to get to e4 square. White knight would come to e4 square, and this is very principal sacrifice. The sacrifice cannot be taken by knight because of the simple fact that white would take on e5, and when black takes back, white is going to take on a g6, and pieces can be on f6. So it has to be taken by pawn. And now white plays move knight e2. So pawn has been sacrificed, but now square e4 is vacant, and white knight is going to get to this square, increasing further pressure on f6 square. Rook f8, black plays. Black wants to actually liberate the knight, because white was threatening, for example, knight e4. And then, in the case that black knight moves, white would take fg6, and white would take on f7. So we move rook f8, black wants to protect f7 square. Queen h4. White is preparing knight e4. Bishop a6, threatening b4, and knight e4. Now what white wants to maybe push move d6 in order to disconnect queen and the knight. Black plays bishop e7, hitting the white pawn, and white plays indeed move d6. Now, well, the knight is no longer protected, so now some exchanges in the center are necessary. But first, black is doing something clever. Black takes on e4, white takes with the bishop, and now black gives c4 check, which is important move, because now after king h1, bishop e4, knight e4, White threatens f6, so black plays f6. White does not have move bishop e3. Otherwise, bishop e3 would be possible. But now, because of this check, white has to go for something different. And it is interesting position, because the evaluation of the whole position is decided actually by one small tactical detail, which had to be seen long ahead. So white takes fg6, threatening mate on h7, black takes, and white takes a pawn on f6. Knight f6, and now we have very important moment, because if white takes knight f6, black would have a defense in rook f6, rook f6, and now queen d8. Queen is pinned, and after, let's say, move like rook f8, rook f1, black would take bishop f6. Now rook f6 is impossible because of queen g7, so queen f6 has to take. And then after queen f6, rook f6, white is not even better in this position, because black is having 3 versus 2, pawns are very fast, and white king is very badly placed. So white had to take on f6 with a rook. And now, for example, the simple question is, what happens if black plays bishop f6, knight f6, king g7. Because if white plays queen h7, black plays king f6. White can give black a few checks, he can chase his king, but there is no mate. On the other hand, black is now exchange up and threatens to take queen d6, for example. So how does white continue? White has the only one way in rook f1. White now threatens queen h7 mate, but rook h8. Well, now black is exchange up. If white queen will move, it will not be so good for white, but white has excellent tactical resource in a knight e8 check, rook e8, queen f6, king h7, and now move rook f3. And white comes with the rook h3 and mate. And black is in such a bad shape that he cannot even sacrifice queen for the rook. So it is going now to be mate in 2. And this is very important tactical resource, which white player Salem had to see much ahead. This tactical resource had to be seen. Otherwise, this whole combination would have been wrong, and black would have excellent game. So black understood that white has tactical resource, which he did. This, which is also a compliment for a black player, because it means that black player, in order to play move queen d8, he basically saw the whole combination with knight f6 check, rook f1, and knight e8 check. And therefore, black went for a queen d8. But now white is having a positional advantage. Rook f8, queen f8. Here, for example, white could have played move rook d1 with a clear positional advantage, because knight is strong, black king is weak, and pawn is dangerous, advanced. But Salem calculates direct win. He played move knight g5, threatening mate in 1 on h7. Now let's see what can black do. If black plays move queen to d6, taking the pawn, then there is move rook f1, cutting the king's escape, and now queen h7 is going to mate. If queen g4, which is, if queen f5, which is a logical move, if king g1 would be played with the idea to give a check on h7 and rook f1 winning the queen, then black has strong response in a move e4 and bishop b4 check. But white has a resource in a move g4, excellent resource in the position. And then after black plays, let's say black cannot play move queen f4 because of queen h7 check, king f8, knight d6, winning the queen. And now black actually, black does not have a good square for the queen. White is now, if queen d3, which is the only move to cover f1 square, now white is winning check, king f8, check, only move. Check. King. Take c6, check. King b5, check. King d6. Queen a8. And queen is protecting white king from a check. And in the case of, let's say, e4, to reintroduce this queen f3 check, there is queen d8. This is also one long variation which Salem had to see. Black player played move bishop h6. But bishop h6 now loses to different problems. Knight e6, queen takes d6 only move. Now queen f6 would be a bad move because of queen d3. But white has a strong response in a queen e4, hitting the rook and threatening to take on g6. So black has to now give exchange. Queen e6, queen a8 check, king h7. Now most probably move queen a5 is going to also win the game here. I mean, white is now having winning advantage. But white would prefer black e-pawn not to advance in order not to give black some unnecessary counterplay. So white plays move rook e1. And now black cannot advance his e-pawn. At the same time, white is threatening, let's say, queen a5 or queen b7, checking b5. So black plays bishop c3, no, bishop d2, the only active source. Rook d1, c3, takes on c3, takes with the bishop, and now comes very unpleasant check for black, queen a7. And king does not have a good square, because if king would go to 8th rank, rook d8 mate would happen, and if king goes up to h6, then there is a check on e3, winning a piece. So black has resigned. It was quite a nice 4-pawns attack against Benoni, and nice dynamic attacking win for the best UAE player. That was today game of the day, game of the 8th round of Abu Dhabi Masters. Regards from Abu Dhabi, good night.